So I'm going to start with you, Peter, if that's all right.
Thank you, Ron, and thank you everyone for attending here tonight. My name is Peter Burke. I'm a chartered accountant here working in Stevens Cook and Associates. Working in Stevens Cook and Associates in Blackhall Place in Mullingar. I've been there for the last 10 years, it's hard to believe now, since I left college, so I've been working in the town. Since I was elected, which is in 2009, for the first time at the local elections, on that occasion, just a year and a half afterwards, I opened an office there in Mary Street, you might be aware of it, to serve the constituency I was elected in and the Greater Mullingar area. It's very difficult to say, I suppose, in terms of when you're working with businesses through this hugely challenging economic environment, what single thing you're going to do. I'm not a guy that goes around making promises, I never have. But what I would say is that my door is always open to represent people in the area and to provide a first-class service to anyone who needs it, and to represent them through Westmeath County Council as well, using all the powers at my disposal to do that. As a councillor, I have a record there for 4.5 years of working on the council, and I'm the only councillor in the county who has pioneered two variations of the county development plan, which I wasn't there at the inception last time, and one of them is directly dealing with businesses. So I'm, as I said, based in Mullingar, been there all my life, and happy to serve in any way possible.
Thanks very much, Peter. Chris?
Hi, good evening. My name is Chris Weldy. Brief history. Educated in Bray and UCD. Moved down to Mullingar in 1984. And as Ronan said, fell in love with the place and got married here and settled here. Over the time since I arrived, I have worked in various businesses around the town. Number of years as assistant manager down in Mullingar Harbour, and 20 years ago joined the fire brigade here in town as well. What I'm going to do, if I get elected, if I'm lucky enough to be granted the honour of being elected, is, I think councillor is the wrong word, facilitator is a better word, it's a word I don't particularly like, but you do hear a lot these days. I think the job of a member of the council is to allow, as Peter said, support individuals and enterprises, businesses, business people, and community groups, to support them when they come to you and say, look, we have an idea to do such a thing, be it a project to either bring tourism into the town or the county, right? To increase the size of their business, to improve the quality of the business they're doing so that they can generate more employment, to facilitate them in doing that, represent them, channel them in the right direction, and at the same time, give them any assistance they can. Because let's face it, we walk down the main street any day of the week and there is a business closing somewhere. And there are so many pressures on people. There's so many pressures on business. Margin is so small, shoplifting is a problem, all kinds of things. But if we don't sustain the jobs we already have, never mind build on the jobs we need to create, we go nowhere. To turn around and say, oh, well, we've announced this many jobs this week in whatever town or county around the country, is a good thing. But if, on the other hand, you're losing all the local businesses out of the centre of town, because of the pressures of rates, rent, overhead, insurance, and all the other problems we have that we could list out in 10 pages of stuff, you're going nowhere. You're only solving half a problem, but creating another one. So that's what I would hope to do.
Thanks very much, Chris. Laura, you said, and also about the area you're running in, because there's two more yards.
Hi everybody, my name is Emma Dartson, I'm in Mullingar and Cool. I feel very much the John Humphreys of this because I'm going to talk about facts and figures here. Mullingar has been neglected. The IDA invested less than 1% of its overall budget last year here. This time has many strengths. It was a strong drilling market time, it can be that again. If Mullingar was supported, it should be a key logistics area for all of Ireland. We have an excellent road network and we're at the centre of the country. It's great news, I'm sorry that the town council is gone, but it's great news that you're now accessing road development funding. The way that the European pillars work, the funding that is rural development funding applies to all of Ireland apart from Dublin and Cork. So I'm sorry to say that the people of the town of Mullingar are in fact rural. And that funding is there to support sustainable community development. It is also to identify as quickly as possible gaps, identify that need and get the business up and running. Today we were in the town of Martin McGuinness, who was so impressed with the small business models that are in this town and the businesses that are successful. We were in with Eamon Grady and he couldn't believe that a young man like Eamon was investing in this business and hoping to grow it. He thought the positivity was just fantastic. We were also in with O'Malley's, who are always an interesting shop to go into. We actually thought we wouldn't get anybody out of it. Everybody was in the shelves and the shelves. That's what Mullingar needs. It needs an identity. It has an incredible business culture. It has a just delightful market character of small businesses that really should be built on some more. Tourism is very important. We need to start looking at what our anchors are. We need to look to see what makes us a destination, and we need to be looking at that. Tourism is a huge factor for this area, and someone shut the door on it 15 years ago. They have directed everybody, it's like a donut. Everybody goes around the periphery. We are peripheral to everything. Mullingar's peripheral to services, peripheral to development, peripheral to IDA development, peripheral to tourism development. I mean, Martin McGuinness is a fly fisherman and he stood in O'Malley's mouth, but nobody would have course fishing here. He said, no, we're some of the best trout fishing in the country. But no one knows that because no one's advertising it for you. And people should be more angry about that. And it's just everyone's exhausted doing their work. So that would be my logistics, rural development funding, and supporting existing businesses so that they can invest in their future development. Thank you.
Thank you. Eden, what happened?
It's working all right, honestly. Maybe they don't want to hear it, but it's having a bit of I suppose my name is Eden Davis. Thank you.
You're auctioning it off after.
I'm auctioneering here with a business here, Sherry Fitzgerald Abbott in Davos. I suppose the fancy term is the managing director at Innes. We've an office here in Mullingar and an office in Castle Pollard. I employ 10 people directly here in Mullingar and Castle Pollard. So I suppose I have an in-depth knowledge of what it takes to run a business through good times and through bad times. And we've seen a hell of a lot more bad times in the recent past and good ones, as most people know, sitting on the floor there. The key issues or the bits and pieces you asked, but I suppose just briefly as well, I have strong links to the community here and we have a heavy involvement with the GAA, as quite a lot of people would know. The key issues I have been involved with recently here, the reduction in levies, construction levies, particularly to larger companies they're quite considerable. And I remember meeting with the manager here and I said, really, look, we have to look at these. I met him 2 years ago, we talked again about 18 months ago, and a little less than a year ago, our last manager, Danny McLaughlin, reduced the levies, which was a huge help to Merlin at the time. We were talking to Pat Byrne, we met Pat Byrne at the time, but they were looking at development, and also Patterson Pumps. And both of these are actual things that, you know, have happened and are happening at present. Out of, as some of the people used here, being a conduit or whatever else, and being proactive and getting results. A couple of other things, I suppose. things I would like to see maybe is your ass run, and I know it's something that, that's come up with the street strategic committee that you've had. I know Jim Buck was chairman of it. I don't just see Jim here tonight, like there's Bertie, there's probably people here running, and lots of people are here that are on that committee at present. And one idea that I had seen in action before, and I know there's one in Carroll, I think in Limerick Town as well, is a town manager. And I think that is something that we really need. And I have discussed it with our new manager since he's come in, and the new manager seems to be, it's pushing an open door. Now I know our local TV, Robert Troy, has also floated the idea, and I know that committee are, I think, due to meet the manager soon enough, I think, or somebody from your committee probably will talk or whatever else, but that's something that I think would be a huge help to the town going forward. The concept would be that they would run the town, you would have a go-to person in the council, and it would run the town as if the manager of Blanchardstown Shopping Centre or whatever, this, you know, a similar type thing. As I said, Limerick Town itself, or city, has a town manager, Colin Crossdale, town manager, and he is the direct conduit with the council and with the manager and with the business people.
Hello everybody, my name is Pat Holmes. I grew up not 100 yards from this building. I spent all my youth in Bishopgate Street. When I was about 18, I went and joined Aer Lingus, and I was out of the town for 20 years, but I returned back in 2000. And for my sins, I ended up at a Crooked Wood, a beautiful part of the country. But Mullingar is where I was born and bred, and my heart is no more than grown. I'm getting into politics. I've made my case of putting my name forward to be counted. We've all talked the talk, and there's a lot of people here that are politicians and have walked around the town before and tried to canvass. They get a lot of guff and they get a lot of noise from people or whatever, and no more than myself have done it. But I said, no, there's no more talking. I need to walk the walk. I need to let people know that I want to have change. Now, I know we're talking about Mullingar, we're talking about Mullingar business, but I'm talking about the whole county. It is the county council that we're looking for election to. And back to what Linda said there, Mullingar seems to be a hole in the centre of this county. And there is so much potential that this town can do for itself. The choices that we have in this town, and one thing, she mentioned about lakes and fly fishing. We have a canal running right to the centre of this town. In the years I've been down here, we've seen wonderful development by the Waterways of Ireland to redevelop that amenity, but it is not sold, either inside or outside this county, as something that people can use as a strong amenity. And if it is a strong amenity that brings people onto the water, you look in England or you look in France, people go to these countries to go on canal holidays, and doing that, they travel through towns and travel through places that they would never thought before and walk out into the communities that they're meeting there. That is where I would be focused on my tourism side of things. I really feel that the canal is dead centre. We have our lakes, we're called the Lakelands. They can be sold as the wonderful things they are, but the canal will bring people to the centre of this town. In my sense of tourism, it's also part of the business structure, because the more flow you have of people in a town, the more people will peruse shops, walk into businesses, look for amenities, look for a cup of coffee. And I have to say, onto myself, my own business and audiovisual installations, but with the downturn that happened, I've actually opened a cafe. I have to keep working, I have to do things. I can sell you a good cup of coffee, but anyone that walks into the town, I would like to give them the choices of good food. Westmead hams, Westmead vegetables, whatever. These can be sold out into the community that we want to bring into Westmead. Now, I, for the first time ever, because I also get involved in politics, went to my first county council meeting during the week, the last one of the current period, and I saw how it operates, and I can see that there is importance for independent voices in a county council. It is true independent voices that new ideas can be brought to the fore that are not hampered by any party or any strategies that are trying to gain a party system. As I've said in my leaflet here, it's about people politics, not party politics. It's to do with the people of the community we live in, and that is from all the way up to Finney, right down to Kilbeggan or Charles Pass or whatever. It is the county that we have to work for. And if the county is getting strong, the towns will get strong. And Mullingar, the centre where the county council meets, will be the benefit of the strength of that. So I put myself forward, I'm walking the walk, I'm walking the street and meeting people. I hope to bring plans forward to show what I want to do. I'm not on committees because I'm new to all of this, but I want to put my voice forward. I want to strive for Mullingar and Westmeath to be a better place. Thank you.
Thanks,
can you hear me now? Is that okay? Yeah. Jerry Shipton is my name. I've been a town councillor since 2009 when I retired from Westmeath County Council, where I worked for over 30 years in numerous positions. And I would regard myself as a very serious community activist. I work in close liaison with numerous residents' associations, some of which I formed recently. For example, in Rathoan, a vibrant community there, I was responsible for forming a residents' association in the middle of the village, a small little community which now is pride of the place of Rathoan, and I'm working closely with that group. In addition, for example, in Rochford Bridge, I work closely with three different residents' associations in the major estates. So I think you just couldn't pigeonhole me as a Mullingar Town Councillor. I've been active on the campaign trail here since last May, and I think that I have certainly a very genuine commitment to politics, to community, to community life, which I think is very important and is very critical. I would be seen as a man who engages with people in the estates, and there obviously Raheem Farron, I would be very well known, Grange, because I would be involved on a day-to-day basis. For example, tonight I have to return to Grange to deal with 5 queries. So, you know, that's my type of involvement, and I think obviously, hopefully, that the people will give me a strong mandate come the May the 23rd. It's been a difficult time. No doubt, but when you have the work done, when you have been a man of the people, I think that's what I think will count. So, just from that perspective, but getting back to what I can offer Mullingar.
We're under time constraints, Chair.
Oh, okay, but just, just in relation to Mullingar, I would be very much in favour of rates reduction. I'm a former rates officer with Westmeath County Council, and I think the legislation there hasn't been changed since 1857. So we need to reduce, we need a complete overhaul of the rate system.